Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to learn about time of flight of the particle, maximum range, horizontal range as well as the greatest height reached by the particle. So let's get started. Time of flight. So what do you mean by this time of flight? The time of flight is nothing but the time taken by the particle for the horizontal range is called time of flight. For example, let us say this is x-axis as well as y-axis, and suppose a particle starts projected from the point O. Then the particle reaches the x-axis. Now time of flight means the time taken by the particle to reach this x-axis. So this is called time of flight and it is denoted by capital T. The time taken by the particle for the horizontal range. Horizontal range means it is x-axis. Horizontal range is called the time of flight. If capital T be the time of flight, for the horizontal range, then the vertical distance traveled by the particle is zero. So in diagram, as you know that if the particle starts from the point O and if it reaches the point M, then the time taken by the particle to reach from the point O to the point M is called time of flight, whereas this OM is called as the horizontal range. This OM is called as horizontal range. Then if the particle starts from the point O, then what is the vertical distance traveled by the particle? Vertical distance traveled by the particle is equal to zero. Okay, therefore we know that y is equal to u into sine alpha into t minus half of gt square. You can see the equation number 6 from the equation of the or derivation of the path of the particle, that is y is equal to u sine alpha t minus half of gt square. Now in this case we have to put small t is nothing but I have taken here capital T. And the vertical distance traveled by the particle is equal to 0 means y value is equal to 0. So if you substitute both the values, left hand side you will get y value is equal to 0 u sine alpha into capital T minus half of the g t square. Now transpose half of the g t square to the left hand side. If you transpose this to the left hand side, you will get 1 divided by 2 g t square is equal to u into sin alpha into t, where one of the t get cancels. If one of the t get cancels means, how can you write? That is 1 divided by 2 g into capital T is equal to u into sin alpha, and then transpose this 1 by 2 g or g divided by 2 to the right hand side, you will get t is equal to 2 u sin alpha divided by g. This is the time of flight, the time taken by the particle to reach the horizontal range. Now next one, horizontal range. Horizontal range. So what do you mean by horizontal range? The distance between the point of projection and the particle where it crosses the x-axis or crosses the horizontal plane. And is denoted by capital R. Suppose, so I have already shown in the first figure, say this is the point of projection, and if the particle starts projected here and if it crosses the x-axis or the horizontal plane, then this range is called as the horizontal range. If you take m, so om is equal to horizontal range, and we know that horizontal range is denoted by capital R, and then R is given by along the line, means you can write it as velocity is u. This velocity is u, and there are two components of the velocity. Towards the x-axis you can write it as u into cos. Here angle is equal to alpha, so it is u cos alpha, and with respect to time means multiplying with respect to time, that is u cos alpha into t. Now substitute the value for t. T is nothing but time of flight, so that is u cos alpha into t value is equal to 2u sin alpha divided by g. This is equal to, I will write 2, this u into u is equal to u square. I will write only u square, and then this 2 into sin alpha into cos alpha, we can write it as sin 2 alpha. 2 into sin alpha into cos alpha, we can write it as sin 2 alpha. This is the required range. R is equal to u square sin 2 alpha divided by g. So next one, maximum range. Maximum range. So what do you mean by maximum range? The horizontal range is maximum if sine 2 alpha is maximum. Sine 2 alpha is maximum. That is, we know that R is equal to U square into sine 2 alpha, U square into sine 2 alpha divided by G. Then this is called actually range, and this range is maximum if this sine 2 alpha is maximum. And sine 2 alpha is maximum at what angle? At 90 degree, because sine 90 is equal to 1, which is the maximum value, and sine minus 90 is equal to minus 1, which is the minimum value. So sine 2 alpha is equal to pi by 2. That implies, means 2 alpha is equal to pi by 2 at angle, not sine 2 alpha, only 2 alpha. So that is, this 2 alpha, sine 2 alpha is maximum, that is at point angle pi by 2. So 2 alpha is equal to pi by 2, means alpha is equal to pi by 4. So if you throw a particle from the point of projection with angle 45 degree, then the particle reaches the maximum range. Therefore, because sine 2 alpha is maximum, means sine 2 alpha is equal to 1. Sine 2 alpha is equal to 1, and sine 2 alpha is equal to 1 means this is sine pi by 2, and therefore 2 alpha is equal to pi by 2. So alpha is equal to pi by 4. Hence maximum range is, therefore R is equal to U square divided by G into sine 2 alpha value is equal to 1. This is R is equal to U square divided by G, which is the maximum range. Now, greatest height reached by the particle. Greatest height reached by the particle. We know that x dot is equal to u into cos alpha, and y dot is equal to u sine alpha minus gt. At the highest point, the vertical velocity should be zero. If capital T be the time taken by the particle in reaching the highest point, then from the above equations, so in this case, let us say this is x-axis, and if the particle starts projected from the point O, it goes like this, and it reaches the highest point as and when the velocity decreases. When the velocity becomes zero, the particle starts moving downwards. Now we have to find this is the highest point reached by the particle. So now to find this, we know that y dot is equal to u sine alpha minus g into small t. Now put y dot is equal to 0, because the vertical velocity, when the vertical velocity is 0, then the particle reaches the highest point. And let us say the time taken by the particle is capital T. Okay, now that is 0 is equal to u sine alpha minus g into capital T. Therefore, gt is equal to u sine alpha, or t is equal to u sine alpha divided by g. Therefore, the greatest height attained by the particle, is, okay, that is nothing but we have to find the value for. This is nothing but y value. This is the greatest height reached by the particle, and this is nothing but y value. But what is the value for y? Y is equal to u sine alpha into capital T minus half of g t square. I have taken t is equal to capital T. Now put the value of t. Substitute this value of t in this equation. That is, put t is equal to u sine alpha divided by g. What happens? That is, y is equal to u sine alpha into, substitute the value for this t. If you substitute the value for t, t value is equal to u sine alpha divided by g minus half of g. T square means, again, that is u sine alpha divided by, or directly I will write u square sine square alpha divided by g square, where one of the g get cancels. So y is equal to this u sine alpha, and this is u sine alpha, total it is u square sine square alpha divided by g. The remaining term is, one of the g get cancels, means minus 1 by 2 u square sine square alpha divided by g. So this is equal to, both are same, if you take u square sine square alpha divided by g common, 1 minus 1 by 2, on simplifying you will get 1 by 2 u square sine square alpha divided by g, or simply you can write that is u square sine square alpha divided by 2g. So this is the maximum height or highest point reached by the particle.